Hello, Sunny. Apologies. Oh, I'm so well. Hello, hello. How are you?
Great.
Oh, good. I have to say I have a cold, so I apologize if I sound a bit croaky. But it started last week and yesterday I thought it was going, and today it's come back, so which isn't very nice. So I apologize, but you at least you can't catch it through the screen, which is good. Because I think I've caught it off one of my students, funny enough. We have some water. So what have you been doing this week, Sunny, since I've seen you? What have you been doing at your school? What have you been studying this week?
Next week we have a exam.
Oh, wow. Okay. What is your exam? What subject?
All subject.
Oh, all subject. So it's like a general exam. Oh, okay. Let me just put that in. That's a good one. I haven't, we'll discuss this. Let me just put the get the screen up. Gosh, my sinuses. It's annoying because yesterday I was thinking, oh, I'm really good. And today I'm thinking I'm not really good. Right. So all subjects. What oops. What do you call that type of exam? What do you, if it's a is it I mean, I don't even know in English, all subject, is it like we could call it a general, I can spell this word. Sorry, I'm getting there. A general proficiency test. Does that make sense? A general proficiency. Like proficiency, which I'm sure I have spelt right, even though I will check. Proficiency, yeah, that's what I put. Yeah, proficiency. Yeah, proficiency. If you put it into the thing, proficiency. Yeah, I think that's right. Let me just check. Sorry, I'm definitely dopey today. Yeah, no, I have. Proficiency. Does that translate?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, I mean, we have in England, at certain times in the schooling, we will give a general test on not a specific, not specific, you know, general. General, not specific. It's different. Is that what you mean? A test on everything, or is it like one exam, or is it like many, many exams?
Many exams.
Oh, okay. Oh, I'm wrong then. Sorry. I thought you meant, because sometimes usually when you're younger, we had much younger, in fact, in England, we used to have a test when you were 11 called the I don't remember what it was called now, but basically it was if you put, it was an exam on mathematics, English, science, basic things. And if you reached a level, it was like a proficiency test. So if you reached a level, that meant you went to a different school. Whereas if you didn't reach such a good level, you went to a maybe a not such a good school. It was very unfair because I expect, you know, with exams, at 11 and you are 15 now, is that correct? You're 15 years? Yeah. I mean, you can have a bad week. You know, you can have a bad week at 15. To judge you on things now at 15 is not the same as judging people at 20. And, you know, for me, this is my personal feeling. What do you think about that? Learning is lifelong. Does that make sense?
Yes.
I believe that. You know, well, I'm an example perfectly is me talking with you, because when I was your age, there were no computers. There was no internet. You know, there were books, and you went to a library and you read the books in the library, or you had books at your home, or you had books in your school library, and or you talked to people to learn things. And but you have to hopefully acquire new skills to continue to learn, you know. It's very important, I think. You know, I am learning new skills even now, and to keep me, I think, connected to the world. Connected to the world. I'll tell you why. I mean, can you, well, it's interesting. I want to ask you, can you imagine a world without the internet? What would you do if you had no internet?
Maybe draw painting.
Painting or music. You could play your music.
Yeah.
Which is great. Or and you could read. You could read. But if you can imagine, I mean, it's a perfect example. When I was a child, on television in England, how many television stations, how many channels do you think there were available to watch on television?
One.
No, there were three. There was three, basically. But they didn't start in the morning. They started at usually midday, and then they finished at maybe midnight. There was nothing in the morning. There's no 24 hours television. And if you missed something, if you're going to watch a serial, say it was your favorite program, there were no video recorders, no recording, so you could not miss something. So sometimes your friends would say, "Hey, do you want to come out to a party?" And you'd say, no, I've got to watch this program, because I will not be able to see the next part, because it was never repeated. And and there were many things like that. It was just life, you know. I can remember not going to a party once because I was watching a tennis match on television, and I really wanted to watch this match. And so I went to a party about 4 hours later, because this tennis was important to me, for me to watch. And it's different, but you know, it. I don't know what you think about this statement. Sometimes it's difficult to change. And I don't mean your clothes, I mean your ideas. To change, I think I'll put ideas in much better. Ideas. So for instance, if you didn't have the internet, say tomorrow, aliens came to Earth and they switched off the internet. So there was no more internet. How do you think you would deal with that? What would you do? Would you be okay?
Yeah, because before I came to high school, I don't have a phone.
Oh, okay, that's good. That's interesting. So that's very good. I think that's a very good idea. Why did that happen? Why did that happen? Your
because
parents?
Yes, because we need to study for the gen proficiency test.
Oh,
and
you
we
did the general. Yeah, excellent. Yeah.
Yes, and we will go to different high school. So
oh, okay, that's interesting.
We are
studying. I think it's good. You're right. I think it's good because without a phone, you have to look around the world and look at things. You have to look, you have to really look and listen. And I mean, example, I don't know if I've ever told you this, but my father, who sadly, he died when I was young, but my father could not, I don't know if you know this word. I can't even spell it. Do you understand what that word means? What does it translate?
People who can read or they haven't
All
studied.
right. Yeah. Well, no, it's not often they're studying. It's just that basically my father came from a very, very poor family. He lived on the coast of England and not in a big city, a very small city. And his family were poor and he had many brothers and sisters. He was the youngest child. He had very, very bad eyes. He could not see very well, really, really bad eyes. And so, I mean, his glasses were like thick, like, you know, it was crazy. But when he was a child, they never had money to buy him glasses. So he did not have reading glasses. So because he did not have reading glasses, he could not see words. And then he left school when he was 12. Can you believe that? He finished school when he was 12 and went to work. And he worked with his hands. But he learned so much about the world because he was a very, very intelligent man. He didn't have education, formal education. I'll put that in. He didn't have formal education. He couldn't read books, but he learned from doing. That's a great, you know, I don't know if you know this. Learn from doing. So basically, he learned to make things. He became a builder. He built houses. But he was very interested in the world and nature and many things. And I did not know as a child he could not read. Because he always had a newspaper, but my mum would read him the newspaper. And he would, you know, tell us things about the world, which were amazing. And it wasn't until after he died that I discovered he couldn't read and write. And I was very sad for him because I thought he'd missed out so much. Now I think, yes, it's true, he has missed out so much. But sometimes now the world is so fast with everyone on their phones the whole time that you don't stop to look outside at the world. You know, it's a nature. And So there is much about education, which is amazing. And I think learning life, like I said, lifelong learning is so important, but it's learning about everything. You know, it's not just little things, but big things. Crystal, hello. Are you there, Crystal?
Hello.
Hello, are you okay?
Fine.
Excellent.
Okay.
You're good. Okay, have we, I can't remember, did you, you didn't come to the last class, did you? I can't remember, were you in my last lesson? I was just looking at my list. Yes, you were in my last lesson. So how are you this week?
Just normal.
Normal, okay. That's
yes.
good. Normal is good. As you can hear, I'm sorry, I have a cold, so my voice is a little croaky today. It's a little croaky, and I'm just having some water. I have a cold. It was going, but now I think it's slightly come back, which is annoying. So I apologize if you can't understand my voice very well. I'll try. We're talking about learning, just to start with, because Sunny was saying she has a test next week. And and I was saying about learning is lifelong. Do you understand what I mean? It's like
yes.
we constantly have, I think it's very important, no matter what age you are. I mean, my mum, God bless her, is getting quite old. She is 95, my mum, 95. But she's still learning new, she's still doing new things. She's still, you know, she's still very active with her mind. And she plays cards in a game. It's a game called Whist. I don't know if you know, I can't play it. It's a game with cards, and it requires a lot of memory and counting. And my mum plays twice a week in a big group of people. She plays with 30 people, 30 people cards. And sometimes she wins. She wins. She gets the highest score of everyone. And she's really good. She's a really good card player, my mum. So it shows that you can do many things to keep your brain active.
Mm-hmm.
And so I would encourage you, if you have good, you know, if you know your grandparents and sometimes they're a bit like, oh, well, I can't do anything, I'm old. Mm-hmm. And to encourage them, encourage them to learn new skills, because literally anyone can do it, and it's very good for your memory. I think that's my opinion, but I think it's very good. And I was telling Sunny that when I was young, when I was very young, there was only a very few television channels. I mean, let me ask you, Crystal, what would you do if there was no internet? What would you do to have fun and pleasure?
I will read books.
Read books, great. So actually, I'm going to ask everyone, read books. Sam!
Hi, Greg.
Hi there, mate. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Yeah, I'm okay. I have a cold, but hopefully you can still hear my voice.
Okay.
We're just talking about what would you do if there was no internet? Now, I'm guessing Sam comes from a time like me before the internet. So what did you do before the internet for entertainment, for pleasure, for hobbies?
Okay.
What did you do?
First, maybe I think I just can watch the TV.
Well, okay, watch TV.
Yeah.
Good.
And
watch.
Yeah, watch TV.
Now, and how many, when before the internet, how many channels were there on television?
Oh, okay. In Taiwan, if we watch the cable, it's about maybe 50 to 100 channels.
Oh wow!
Cable,
50,
yeah,
100
only
channels.
Cable, yeah.
To 100 on cable. I mean, I can tell you, in England, when I before the internet and before. There wasn't really cable. There wasn't really cable in England. There were three channels, only three.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, three channels on the on television. Then there were four, and then I think in 1982 there were four, and then I think in 1990 there were five,
mm-hmm.
and they were the only channels you could get. And
mm-hmm.
It was really interesting because you really watched television because there wasn't so much else to do, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But also, I think I grew up learning. I had, I don't know if you know this word, hobbies. Does that make sense? Hobbies. Do you know
yes.
that word?
Yeah, I
you
know
see
you.
That word and Crystal as well. Hobbies. I make things. Even now, I like making things and repairing things. I mean, I don't know
okay.
if I can show you something I've been repairing even now. Can I show you?
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, I can. I'll quickly grab something. I was repairing this the other day. Yeah, so this week I had this necklace, which is lovely.
Wow.
Well, actually, this is a good question. What is this? What is the green? Does anyone know the name? I'll try and put it closer. It's a stone.
Jade?
No. It looks like jade. It's the right colour. It's another stone. And it's got lots of lines in it. I don't know if you can see the little lines. So it's probably not focusing. There's another bit there.
Oh.
It's natural. The black is natural. Do you know what the mineral is? It's called turquoise. Turquoise.
Turquoise.
Yeah, it comes from the name of the country, Turkey. That's originally where it came from. Yeah, it's a mineral. It's a beautiful mineral. And also it's known as, that is also a color in English, turquoise. It's a mixture of green and blue. So
mm-hmm.
you can see it's not green and it's not blue. It's sort of in between. Now, do you know what the red is? It's a bit hard to see the red. That is also natural. It's a natural mineral.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know the name of the red stone?
No.
No. Sunny, do you know?
No.
Okay. Crystal, do you know?
No.
Okay. It's another thing. It's under the sea. It's coral. Sorry, I'll put it in a separate line. Coral. Have you heard of coral? It's in the ocean. Coral. So this is a, as you can see here, it's a coral necklace.
Uh-huh.
And what I did was I put the new chain on. So I got this chain.
Okay.
And I repaired the necklace to make it wearable, so I can give it to one of my sisters. And it opens, if I can open it. and it is adjustable, so it can be longer or shorter. So that is one of my hobbies, to repair things, because this was broken and I repaired it. Do you have any hobbies, Sam?
Yes, my hobbies, let me think. Just do some outdoor exercise.
That's good.
Yeah.
Outdoor exercise. It says spelling it exercise wrong. Oh, sorry. Not coral outdoor exercise. Okay, that's a good one. Crystal, what hobbies do you have?
I think read books.
Reading books. Reading books. That's good. And I think I know what Sunny's hobbies are. I know one of them. Sunny, what is your hobby?
I like
playing the guitar.
And painting.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that.
Reading Greek mythology.
Oh, wow. Wow, that's good. I'm going to write all those down. Playing the guitar or painting. And not petting, painting. And reading Greek Reading Greek mythology without an extra O. Wow, that's good. That's amazing. We will talk about Greek mythology one day because that's very interesting. I think Greek mythology is a very interesting thing. Very interesting, in fact, subject. And philosophy. You should read Greek mythology and you should read Greek philosophy. Because you can learn a lot. Okay, well, that's good. Well done. So let's go on, because we're going to talk about... Oh, we're going to do Wordle quickly. We're going to do some Wordle. Because it's talking about... let me just get rid of that. Talking about words, it's always good to do Wordle. So, Sam, you can start today. Oh, Jenny's here as well. Jenny. Hi, Jenny. Just wait for Jenny to join. Hello, Jenny.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Fine.
Oh, good. Nice to you could come to the lesson. I have a cold. I apologize if my voice is a bit croaky. Hopefully you can hear me.
Yeah, I can hear you.
I thought it was going, but it's today it's sort of come back. But luckily you can't get my cold because you're behind the screens. We're going to start. We've been talking about words and hobbies. We are going to talk about Shakespeare. We're going to do Wordle. So Sam, give me a 5-letter word.
5-letter word?
Yeah.
Okay.
5-letter word. Any 5-letter word you like.
Okay. Enjoy. ENJOY.
That's a good word. Enjoy. Okay, let's have a look. Oh, wow. 2 letters. That's good. 2 letters. Not in the right place, but 2 letters. So you've got, that's good. Crystal, you can go next. You have to think of a 5-letter word that's got N and O in.
Notice.
Notice. Did you say notice?
Yes, N-O-T-I-C-E.
Yeah, that's not 5 letters, notice, is it? N-O-T-I-C-E, 6.
Oh.
It's a bit difficult because it's hard to think of a word that might have. You could start with N, or the N might go at the end, or the in the middle, or.
Jackie, J A C K Y.
What did you say?
J A C K Y.
J A.
Oh, no.
No, because we need O and N, because J is wrong. J, E, and Y are wrong. Only we need letters with O and N.
O and N.
We mustn't use E, J, or Y. Well, don't worry, so we'll come back to you. Let Sunny have a go. Sunny, do you want to have a go?
I have no idea.
Oh, okay. No letters, no words with N and O in. Five letters.
Horse, but there's no N.
Did you say north?
North.
That's a good one. North. You know, not up. Usually we think north, south, east, west. You know, north. Well, let's see. Did you say Norse? I couldn't quite hear you. But let me just put that in. Oh, no good, unfortunately. We've still got those two letters, but they're in the wrong place. So that means the O and N can't go there and there. Jenny, any idea?
There's a word come to my mind, but after you type in north, it's a wrong word.
Don't worry, because sometimes it's good to use the wrong word because it helps you find the right word. I have to do that sometimes. So tell me what your word is.
But my word come to my mind as noted, but it's wrong
noted. With yeah, yeah noted. And yeah, and also because also, we've used an N and a T-E already.
Yes.
That's not going to help. It's a good word, though. It's a very good word. Sam, back to you. Any ideas?
Let me check here.
Well, I'll tell you what I think is try and think of a word that's got N near the end. You know, like N and G go quite well together. You know, also, there's lots of words, you know, when we do something, mm-hmm. What do you say if you put an N and a G at the end? We are, begins with D, we are, if we do something, we are, and it ends in G, N-G.
Mm-hmm.
Can you say, or,
okay.
Or, if we go somewhere, what do we say in a sentence? We are... If we go somewhere, we are go. What else do we say on the end? If we all go together, mm-hmm. We are all go. And what other letters do we put? Or say we're like, or we are going to do something.
Mm-hmm.
We are do, and then we add some. You can't say. If we do something, we do this. We say we are do, and what other letters? We put three more letters. Can't put my fingers up. Three more letters on the end of on do and go. What other letters do we put? We are doing,
oh,
okay. Or going, okay. Doing.
I
you
see.
Know, it's like you know, it's good one. So. For instance, if you're going somewhere, you say, we are going
mm-hmm.
somewhere, or mm-hmm. we are doing something, or we are mm-hmm. Making something.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's those three letters, I-N-G. So, you know, we've got an O and an N. So if we can think of a word, well, do you want to choose one, Crystal?
Encode, E-N-C-O-D-E.
What did you say?
Encode.
Yeah,
E-N-C-O-D-E.
Yeah, that's too many letters. That's six. Encode.
The first line can put the C-O-D-E in the blank.
Yeah, but you can't have an E because we've used an E already. Do you see what I mean? And it's wrong.
Oh.
Yeah, the grey letters are wrong. The yellow letters are right. Do you see what I mean?
Mm.
Yeah, so if you could think of a word like we were talking about doing and going, choose one of those words. Which one should we choose? Doing or going?
Going.
Going, okay. Right, do you see going? Going, do you see what I'm saying about going? Going, doing, making. It makes sense. Okay, let's have a look. Wow. We almost got it. Well, it's not, they're not in the right order. We've got four letters, but we've got to change the order of those letters because then none of them are in the right place. And we only need one more letter and we're going to find the word. So basically, if you look, and this is where you almost have to do some maths in your head. The O can't be there and it can't be there. The N can't be there and it can't be there. The I can't be there. The G is not there, but it's also not there. So we've got to think of a word which is I know which word it is. I can guess which word it is. It's a bit difficult word, but I will give you a clue. It's connected to language. It's connected to language. I don't know if you'll know this word. Any idea? If you speak, I'll give you a clue. If you speak a local language, people will say, oh, he's got or she has got the local, and they use a word. And this is the five-letter word. And it ends, I can tell you, it ends in O. It ends in O. The O goes there. Now, if the O goes there, can anyone think where the rest of the letters go? And there's one more letter. Any ideas? If there's not that many words that end in O, it's not very frequent, to be honest, in the English language. So it ends in O, and then you have to put the other letters in. What, Sam, I think might have got it.
Oh, No. I have the wrong one. Maybe ignore, but R is not the right letter. Ignore, I-G-N-O-R, is not the, yeah.
No, but you're going in the right direction. You're definitely going in the right direction, Sam, with that. Well done. Jenny, any idea?
I'm still thinking.
Okay, and Sunny, any idea? Crystal, any idea?
I'm thinking.
Okay. Now, I'll give you the last letter. I'll tell you what the other letter is. It's an L. An L. So can you arrange? Well, I'll just put them in any order.
Logging?
No. Now, these are the letters. These are the letters. Now, can you make a word out of those letters? You might not know it. That's the thing. It's not a word that's super common. It's more almost a slang word, actually. quite a good word though to know. Any ideas? Sunny.
Any
no, Sam.
Still thinking.
Okay, Jenny.
No, I just the word just come to my mind. Just login. No.
No, it does begin with L. I'll give you a clue. L is the first letter.
Oh. Okay.
So what do you think the second letter is? Any ideas? It's not an O. It can't be O because look, we put O in there. Put O there.
Lingo. No.
Lingo. Sam. Yes. That's it, Sam. Lingo. Lingo means local language, basically.
Okay.
So if you say to someone, oh, do you speak the lingo? It means you speak the local language, really. And lingo. Well done, Sam. Well done. That's great. That's great. It's a hard one. That was a really hard one. A really hard one. So I was well done. That's excellent. Because it's not an easy one to do that. Right. I'm aware of we're getting on the time. So we're supposed to talk about Shakespeare today. Shakespeare's Globe. But the video that I found, a different video, basically. The video is... it's interesting, but Shakespeare, well, actually, we just see, can anyone name any Shakespeare play? Any Shakespeare play? Anyone? Now, I won't start with Sunny, because I'm guessing she knows a few. So, Crystal, can you name any Shakespeare play? Shakespeare. No Shakespeare. Can you name one play that he wrote? I think interestingly, many of his plays have inspired films. So many films have been made of his plays, and also they've started with the story and they've made it into a film with a different name. But can you name a single play? Any idea?
Romeo and Juliet.
Yes, well done. Well done. Well done. That's really good. Excellent. Well done. That's because you read books, you see. That's why you know that. Well done, Crystal. Sam. Give me another one.
Okay. I also know about Romeo and Juliet.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, that's in a way one of the most famous. There are a few ones with one word, one name, or a king's name even. A king's name.
Kim Very Lear. Famous.
Which one, Jenny?
Kim Lear.
King Lear. Yes, well done. That is a very good play, by the way. And if you haven't had the chance to see it, go and see it or watch a film, because it's about being older and your children. I saw a version, the first time I saw it only about 10 years ago, and I found it very interesting. Very interesting. Because at that time, no one had written plays about old people and how they lose their minds slightly. It was a very good play. Sam, any ideas? Can you name another one?
Hamlet.
Hamlet, yes. Excellent. Hamlet. Well done, we got three. Now I know Sonny's gonna know one. Sonny, give me a play by Shakespeare.
A story is, I don't know the name.
Okay.
It's about the, like, the fairy and four people in
okay. You mean Midsummer Night's Dream? A A Midsummer Night's Dream. Summer Night's Dream. I think you mean that. But a fairy in a wood. A fairy in a wood with different people. Is that right?
Yeah, yes.
Yeah. I mean, one of the most famous ones, which you haven't mentioned, is Macbeth. Oops. It's a really good one. It's all about murder and witches. But also, there's a very, very good one called Richard. Richard the Third. And that's a really good one to look at. But when he wrote his plays, they were performed in a special theatre. sorry. And they built a he built a special theatre once he had a good company of actors. And it was, and they recreated one. He had five theatres originally, I think. And he and they recreated in London, and you can go to see it and watch the plays there. His most famous theatre, and it's called The Globe. And they've recreated it exactly as it was in Shakespeare's time. So it's not a modern theatre. It's a theatre from 500 years ago or 400 years ago. And this is the theatre. So I'm going to show you a little video on the theatre. Right. Can you all see my screen? Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, great. So this is in London, by the river, and it's interesting. Hopefully, subtitles are there.
The Shakespeare Theatre rebuilt recently, but it was originally constructed in the 17th century, and its name is The Globe, which comes from the expression everyone in the world is an actor. The conditions at the time when this would have been built were very different from the way actors work now. It was all done during the day because they didn't have enough money to afford candles to put on the plays at night. So there would have been far more interaction between the public and the actors. And in fact, the groundlings, which were the cheapest seats just under the open cover, they would shout at the actors and throw things at them if they didn't like the play. At the time as well, none of the actors were women because they weren't allowed to be in plays. And also the church was very critical of theatre. It called it the nest of the devil. And it was usually just outside the city walls because it wasn't really allowed in those days. It was seen as something very popular and affordable because, just as I said before, the cheapest seats could be afforded by everyone. So this is where the groundlings stand, and to come here it's only £5 to see a play, and they say it's one of the best places, even though if it rains umbrellas aren't allowed, so you're gonna get wet. But they say it would have been the best place as well because the audience participated, so you were right next to the actor's foot. You could see up his nose, and if he spat down at you, as I said, there's no umbrellas allowed, so it would have been a big problem. But this great participation because the audience can see you, the actors. Everybody's involved in the play, which makes kind of a difference from the typical West End play where everybody's in the dark. Here, you felt like you were really part of it.
It does look
it's mainly by Shakespeare, and they're pretty authentic, even down to the finest details, like the original 17th century underwear. So it's probably not that comfortable. And nowadays, we go and see a play, but back then, the most important thing was the acoustics. It was more important that you heard the play. And so wherever you sat, the more expensive seats were the ones that had the best sound. The stage represents three different elements. The top with the zodiac signs that's painted blue represents heaven or the sky. There's even a trap door you can go come down from. And the stage itself represents the earth, and there's a trap door to go underneath, which represents hell. This round shape kind of increases the sense of participation. The building itself, though, was hard to get permission for, because remember, in the 17th century, it had burned down twice. So to make this thatch kind of roof after the Great Fire of London was pretty tough to do. It took them 8 years to get permission, but they finally managed to go ahead with it. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Not if it's a summer's day in London.
Well, I thought you might enjoy that. But also, what a question for you, and I'm going to play as something else. What also has Shakespeare inspired besides films? He's inspired something else. Because he wrote, what else did he write besides words? He wrote
poems,
yes. He wrote poems. Now, what do poems become often if you put them to music?
Drama.
Put music with poems, they become something.
Drama?
Drama, yes, but they also become songs. They become songs. If you put words with music, you get songs.
Mm-hmm.
And so Shakespeare has inspired songs and many, many songs. And well, I thought this, it's funny, I was trying to find something relevant, but I'm just going to try and get you a sonnet, because we might try and do, if we have time, I might try and do a sonnet, but I think today we won't, because I have to leave at 2 o'clock today, because I have to get across London to meet my other students. But here is something that Shakespeare inspired, which Sunny might know. Sunny, what is this video?
Taylor Swift song.
Yes, Taylor Swift. And this is one of her early hits. And it's basically love story, Romeo and Juliet.
Mm-hmm.
And she made a sort of song of Romeo and Juliet. Now, it's interesting because this is good, but actually there's a very, very funny video version of this, which, well, no, it's not funny, but it's good. It's a gay version of this as well, which someone of my friends sent me, which is very funny because it's exactly this song, but made into a gay version, which is very sweet. It's very charming. And but this is the Taylor Swift song about Romeo and Juliet, really. Here we go. We can have a little bit. Can you both see my, all see my screen, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
We were both young when I first saw you. I close my eyes and the flashback starts. I'm standing there on the balcony in summer air. See the lights, see the party, the fog ends. See you make your way through the crowd and say hello. Little did I know that you were Romeo, you were throwing pebbles, and my daddy said stay away from Juliet, and I was crying on the staircase, begging you please don't go. Romeo, take me somewhere we can be alone. I'll be waiting for the sun to do something. Be the prince, be the princess. It's a love story. Baby, just say yes. So I sneak out to the garden to see you. We keep quiet, cause we're dead if it's you. So close your eyes. See this town full of you. No, cause you told me you I was a scarlet letter. And my daddy said, stay away from Juliet.
Now, that is lovely.
Yeah.
It is lovely. Sunny, what did you think? Sunny's the Taylor Swift expert, so we have to ask her. Sunny, what did you think? Is it good?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, I personally think it, you know, and I used a word last week. I think I was going to share it with you. It's a little bit kitsch. Sorry, for some reason not spelled right. It's a little bit kitsch and it's a little bit twee. For me, it's perhaps got too much sugar. Does that make sense? Too much sugar. Do you understand what I'm saying by too much sugar? it's a bit like if you have a spoonful of sugar and you go, yeah, okay, one spoonful. And then you have another spoonful of sugar and you're like, that's almost too much. And then someone gets another one, goes, eat another spoonful. And you're like, no, stop. And that's what kitsch is. That's what kitsch means, or twee. And it's a bit too sweet. There's another word which is perfect. Cloying. When it's so sticky, you can't speak. And me personally, I like the song.
Mm-hmm.
The video is a bit cloying. It's the crazy thing is, though, she keeps jumping periods with the costumes, which is very weird, because she's talking about Shakespeare, but then she's talking, and she's all the costumes are Jane Austen. So whoever directed it, it made no sense whatsoever. Absolutely no sense. It was like, for me, who knows about history, I'm like, what? She's wearing what? He's wearing what? It's all wrong. But I mean, it is a pop video. But so it's quite funny in a way. But she was very young when she did this video, I think. Now her other videos are much more adult and clever. But I might try and find the other funny version of this, the gay version, which is actually very good. They've slowed her voice down, so she sounds like a man. It's very good and very funny. If I can find that for another day, I will. But guys, thank you so much for today. Thank you for coming. Well done on the Shakespeare, and also the learning about things as well, hobbies and things like that. It's a really good talk we've had. I've really enjoyed it. I will see you next week. Hopefully my cold will be gone by then. I'm hoping, fingers crossed. And I will be able to sound a bit more normal, and we'll find another funny video. Also, I was going to tell you, in 2 weeks' time, I'm doing another class as well. I'm doing lifestyle on a Monday, I think. And it's going to be slightly different to this. And we might be talking about professions and jobs and things that people do. And I might even bring some of my own knowledge about work and people and professions in England, in other countries. But also, I want it to be an exchange of ideas. So we can talk about jobs in Taiwan as well, and how they differ. You know, like, well, example, I mean, you know, the job of someone who makes this. How do you make this? You know, what do you do? You know, so I've got a few ideas. That's starting on April the 1st, I think, which is a Monday. Okay, guys. Well, thank you very much. Well, let me stop sharing for a minute. I wish you well. Lovely to see you all. Thank you for coming today. And don't have too much sugar, I think is okay. I think is my idea. You know, too much is too much. Have a good week. Bye for now. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.
Bye-bye.